Good morning. Downtown in the Deliverance Ministry. Our announcements are as follows. The prayer line will be held on Tuesday, January the 11th, beginning at 7:30 p.m. The prayer line number is 302-202-1104. And the access code to get on the prayer line is 223-291. Please join us on Sunday mornings on Facebook Live at GPDM Church for our Sunday morning worship service. And that begins at 10:45 a.m. And please join us on Wednesday night for our Zoom Bible study. We meet there every Wednesday night to learn the Word of God. That starts at 7:30 p.m. and the Zoom meeting number is 912-0853. And the passcode to get on the Zoom line for Bible study is all caps GPDM13. Again, that number is 912-0853 and the passcode, all caps, GPDM13. Saturday, January the 29th at 2 p.m. will be the graduation ceremony for our very own Sade McClendon. Woo! It's going to be at the McClendon's residence. This is a virtual graduation. Please, they let you know if you plan on attending. Refreshments will be on hand. Sunday, January the 30th, will be the appreciation services for Minister Candace Bridges and Deacon and Sister Myers. Invite someone out to come and let them know how much we appreciate their servitude. Pastor Jesse Chisholm will be our guest speaker, and we will be so delighted to have her here to worship with us. Ninth May Free Crusade will be held at the Langley Community Center in Langley, South Carolina on March 4th and 5th. Service times are Friday at 7 p.m. with Minister Shifley Ryan. Hope I said that right. She's going to be our speaker. Saturday, we will have a brunch and worship hosted by Elder Gordon and Elder McClendon from 12 noon until 1:30 p.m. Saturday evening, Pastor Chisholm will be our speaker. If you plan on attending, please, let Sister Jessica Bridges know if you need hotel accommodation. Please don't wait till the last minute. We will be having a good time in the Lord. This is a reminder to bring and drop off coins for our change drive. And that's on every Sunday. You can bring your change, your loose change, and drop it in the change bucket for our coin drive. Please mark your calendars for the Holy Convocation. Those dates will be June 10th through the 12th. And the pastoral appreciation services will be held in October. And those dates are the 15th and the 16th. We want to say happy birthday and happy anniversary to all those celebrating in the month of January. And of course, today is Sister Cleo's birthday. Happy birthday, Cleo. Now, this is the best time. It is seed time. I will be coming from 2 Corinthians 9:6-7 and Malachi 3:7-12. Please don't forget our pastoral love offering of $25. Bishop McClendon's cash app is 706-306-3133. Again, that cash app is 706-306-3133. And please be mindful that he does not take a monthly offering from the church. The cash app for the church, again, is $GPDM13. And that's all caps. Okay, Malachi 3:7-12. Yet from the days of our fathers, you have gone away from my ordinance and have not kept them. Return to me and I will return to you, saith the Lord of hosts. But you say, wherein In what way shall we return? Will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But you say, wherein have we robbed you? In tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. And try me now in this, saith the Lord of hosts. If I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, so that he will not destroy the fruits of your ground, nor shall the vine of your fruit for you in the field, saith the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, for you shall be a delightful land, saith the Lord of hosts. Now I'm going to do 2 Corinthians 9, 6 through 7. But this I say, he who soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he who soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. So let each one of us, as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. Now if you need a tithe and offering envelope, please raise your hand and Zion will be glad to assist you with that. Thank you. I'm going to turn the service back over to Ellen McClendon.
Amen.
Amen. As we prepare our hearts and minds for giving, if anyone needs a tithe and envelope, please raise your hand. Amen. As Zion will give it to you. Also on Facebook Live, as she stated, the Cash App is $GPDM13. Again, $GPDM13. If you wish to give a pastoral love offering, that is Bishop's cell phone number 706-306-3133. Amen. Amen. At this time, if you will hold your offerings up in the air as we decree and declare over our seeds. Amen. Father, it's not a debt we owe, but a seed we sow. We're sowing for good health. Well, minds made free. Our church building. And today, Lord, we're sowing for strength. The Elder Vanessa's family. As we sow this seed onto good ground, we say, grow seed. We'll see you later. Amen. Coming around giving with an expectation. Amen. If you have any change, you can give it to Sister Mimi at this time, and I will get this jar to her in a second. Amen. Today, amen. We have three dynamic speakers that are going to come forth to bring the word on today. Our first speaker we have is none other than our very own Sister Jessica Bridges. Amen. We thank God for her as I sing the song. Thank God for the growth, amen, that I've seen in her. And she always comes power back with the word, amen. So open your hearts, your minds, and listen to what thus says the Lord this morning. Amen. Amen. Congregation, Sister Jessica.
Amen.
All right, amen, church.
Amen.
Amen. Give honor to God who's head of my life. Give honor to my leaders, Bishop and Elder McClendon.
Amen.
And everyone in their respective places.
Yes, Lord.
So I was tasked to speak today. I don't know how long I have, but I won't be before you long. And I had a different topic, like I always do. But this morning, I could not walk. I could not walk. Like, I was holding on to the rail, I was holding on to the thing. I got a Candace bed like we was children again. And she was like, can you get out my bed? I was like, I'm hurting. And then I was like, well, maybe I ain't gonna go to church today. I'm like, I'm just hurting too bad. I ain't gonna do it. And then she was like, well, last time I got like this from work, Bishop just said put slice on it. I was like, I ain't saying it's not going to do anything for me this morning. Like, I am hurting. My leg was sore. I couldn't walk. And so I laid down and went to sleep. And then I woke up. And I was like, well, Lord, I didn't even finish my message today. But something else came in my spirit. And it says, press your way through.
Amen.
And so I said, Jared, come help me to the bed. Come help me to the bed. So I had Jared help me back to my bed. I said, go get me some ice. And I was just like, Lord, please, because you know if I had to go to work today, I'd be doing everything I could to make sure I get to work on time to clock in, to make sure I had me a check. So Lord, whatever you need to do on my body, just do it so I can press my way through. Because the easy way is to just lay here and be like, I can't walk this morning. And so I just kept limping back and forth, just limping, crying. And I'm gonna go. Everybody go to church. No matter how they feel, I gotta go. I just gotta, and we just kept saying, just keep pressing. And so my word today is just keep pressing your way through. Regardless of how hard it might seem, how much pain you might be, just keep pressing your way through. Just keep pressing your way through. And to go along with that is my scripture. And it took me long, it already took me a long time to get ready anyway, but it took me even longer, and it was blowing a hole, and I'm like, y'all know I'm limping, but I'm coming, don't leave me. And my scripture for today is Ecclesiastes 9:11, and it says, I return and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. Neither yet bread to the wise, nor yet riches to men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happening to them all. And I was like, oh, Lord, I hear that scripture all the time, but this morning it really meant something to me because I really pressed my way through because this morning I could not walk. But the Lord gave me the strength. Oh, Lord.
Come on. Let him use you.
See, when we ask for something, he'll get to us if we really want it.
Amen.
Because we make every excuse. Now, I made an excuse. I was like, I'll just tell Bishop, you know, just put me on the program for next week. I'll talk next week. I'm tired. You know, I work at Chick-fil-A, so, you know, stay off anyway. And I'll just prep myself to go to work tomorrow. I mean, I got to thinking, well, Lord, you give me, you take it away. So what if you take that job to me and I don't even make it to work tomorrow? So I had to press my way through. I had to nag and get on my family nerves and help me get ready. But it was to let me know that God will give me that strength.
That's right.
If I ask for it. And if I keep pressing my way through. So now that I know that I have the strength to get through the week. And it also let me know that my children will see by example that no matter how you feel, when it comes to God, you got to keep doing it. I had a job to do. I was the PA for today. That was a job I had to do today. I had to speak today. That was a job I had to do today. I had to count offering. That's the job I had to do. I can't depend on people to do my job in church when everybody already got their own assignment. So I had to press my way out today to do my task, what God has, and put my job. Because that's the resource and not the source.
Come on.
So I had to come here to get some power, from the source be able to get through my resources. Amen. So my message today is just keep pressing your way through.
Keep pressing.
And I just want my sister to come and sing this song, Press, just for 2 minutes, and that would be the end of my message for today, to press your way through.
My God.
Amen, Chris. Because I sure was wondering why she was in my bed. She had got real comfortable, amen. But I'm glad that she finds my room to be safe for her to come. The atmosphere is very clean in there. So I'm glad that she feels the welcome in my room, amen.
Amen.
Amen. If I can just press in your presence, behold the beauty of your face. If I can just press in your presence and leave all my cares behind me, I will be whole. I still believe I will just lay at your feet. I will be whole, 'cause I still believe I will just praise at your feet, right here in your presence. You call me your own, so Lord, I give you me. You own the world, but yet you still want me. Take my heart and take my mind. Take my soul and never let me go. Take my heart and take my mind. Take my soul and never let me go. Hallelujah.
Amen. If I could just press in your presence. Amen. Let's give it up for Sister Jessica. Awesome word. Hometown word this morning. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to hear from our very own mother, Janice Bridges. Give her a hand clap as she comes forward this morning. And as we continue to press. Amen.
Okay, I was tasked also to bring a word. So on Wednesday, our Bible said we was talking about Jabez. And he had to hear his name, which meant sorrow and great pain is what his mom was in. So she put her cares on him. Every time he heard his name, he had to be remembered or reminded what his name meant. So today, and after Bible study, I was up because I already knew I had to do this. I came up with a willingness to love God. If I got a title my message today, that's what it will be. A willingness to love God. God loves us. We got to be willing to love him back.
Amen.
A lot of the times, I think about what Bishop say.
when we expect for God to do something for us, we got to do something for God. And all God requires us to do is to praise Him. So a lot of times I'll be like, okay, this is unto God. When I say this is unto God, not man, you got to get up and you got to move. Because first of all, we got to think. We want God to move on our bed when we looking for something. Whether it be us being our right mind, good health, our financial blessings so we can pay our bills and do what we got to do to, you know, to live here on this earth. We got to do what we got to do. We first got to do unto God for Him to do unto us. We got to be in our right mind. We got to serve God. And we got to serve Him in spirit and in truth. Y'all, it's a lot I've been learning from going to this ministry, God's Power with Deliverance. So, you know, I've been bouncing around for a long time. And I think the ball done stopped in this court. And that's a good thing for me. Because I'm learning. It's one thing to get up and go to church. But then when you leave church, you back to, you know, your everyday life or whatever. And it's a process when you want to turn yourself over to God completely and fully. Everything that you're doing before that is not going to disappear instantly.
Right.
It can if God removes it. But y'all know we operate in the flesh, so it's a process. And we got to want to do what it is that we're supposed to be doing. We got to want to. Somebody can pray for us all day. I got a good friend, and he has been on drugs for 30-some years.
Oh my God.
And I don't care how much you pray for him, how much you say you know, you ought to be tired. Until he get tired.
That's right.
Until he get tired. He gonna keep doing what he wanna do. And I be like, how can you go 3 or 4 years clean and then just wanna run back to it? I thank God that I have never been on drugs. I thank God that I ain't never had to really have no drink or smoke. Because we don't know what those people are going through when they are going through withdrawals. You know, so we just got to pray for them. And I learned to say, Lord, thank you that ain't never been one of my things. You know, but everybody has a thing that they've been addicted to. And I have too. God, thank you. Y'all, when we went to the food and industrial, I was dancing. Y'all know I don't dance no more, but I used to. But I was dancing in my mind because I'm like, Lord, I am so glad that I ain't got to be out here creeping and sneaking. You know, God took that from me, and that's a life I never want to go back to. When God takes something from you, be glad, praise Him, and thank Him that you're not in the same situation that you were in before you start worshiping God.
Right.
And Lord, that's my mom calling me. She know me in church. hold on for just 1 second. I want to give you this scripture, and I have several, but this scripture is what I have for today. It's 1 John 4:16. So we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us. God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in him. That's the scripture I want to leave with you today. Also, you can go to John 14:23. Jesus answered him, if anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him.
Amen.
I leave these words with you, and remember, we got to love God, and we got to get up, we got to move for God, and we expect for him to move for us.
Amen.
We got to do our part. It's one thing to say you want to do something, but action always speaks louder than words. Amen. This I leave with you. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Let's give it up. it up for my grace. Amen. First, you got a Christian way, amen. Then you have a willingness to love God. Amen. Amen. Awesome word. Amen. At this time, our final speaker will be. It'll be Job chapter 3, and then we're going to go to Job 38. I'm going to start off at Job chapter 3. So while we're getting there, I'll ask you all the questions, which he's already stated today, but does anyone remember Bishop's topic on last week and his closing statement?
Protect your peace at all costs.
Protect your peace at all costs. And he also said what?
Peace be still.
Peace be still, right? And then in his closing remarks, what did he say? Because we are a deliverance ministry, what's going to happen?
We're
going to
be tested.
We're going to be tested. God is going to check our peace. And I think that he has definitely done so. It kind of brought back to my memories earlier this week. I had a little situation going on at the house. And that was like one of the first things that came to my mind was, I guess this is my test that's going on. And I'll just be very transparent, open and honest. What was that? Monday? No, Tuesday? Tuesday, like I had a severe panic attack. It's never happened to me before. I think I scared my pups. Well, I don't know. They didn't really seem too afraid. But it literally felt like my throat was closing. Like, I was trying to handle it on my own in my room at first. I was drinking some water. I think I had to blow the dust off of my inhaler because I had to use it in a while. I had to find that. And then it was getting worse, so it would scare me. So I ran to their room and got her out of the bed. She was asleep, looking at me crazy. But I was like, I can't breathe. At first, I was like, is this COVID? Does it happen like this? Does it just shut you off like this? And it's like, I know in the mix of that was a lot going on. I was doing some planning for some stuff, and some other stuff was going on, and it happened. So, in the mix of that, of course, they set me down. They prayed with me. He calmed me down. He was talking to me. And, like, they'll say my body was shaking. It was just crazy. And so I've seen this happen. I knew what it was because I've seen it happen with my clients. But for some reason, I never thought that it could happen to me. Because I'm one of those people that I have to have stuff under control. And I have to have stuff in order. And I'm one of those people where I plan out my life, right? So this has to be checked off at a certain age. When I get here, I need to have this done. And I've been shown that I can't do that.
you know, because my life is already planned. It's not up to me, it's up to him. And so in the mix of doing all of that, I'm kind of learning along the way that, I mean, I can do what I'm doing, but it's not up to me. I can't make those decisions, so there's no need for me to get all raffled up when stuff doesn't happen according to my plan, because it's to his plan, if that makes sense. And then that was on Tuesday. On Wednesday, lost my godmother, and then Saturday, this happened. So it was a lot transpiring throughout the week. So when trying to find something to talk about today, it brought me back to the story of Job, because this is my favorite book that I like to go to if I feel like I'm going through a lot, because it's like what I'm going through is nothing compared, but it also shows me as well that this was one of the most faithful people. And I know I'm not the most faithful to God. I can admit that I have made excuses, you know, to God of why I can't do certain things, come to church, pray, et cetera, et cetera. But this is one of the most faithful people. So if he was tested, why wouldn't we be tested as well? So, okay, turning to Job. And so one of my other questions was, how can we continue to pray and keep faith during difficult times? What are some of the things that we tend to do as believers in Christ? Of course, we all go through, especially in Deliverance Ministries. And I'm not going to lie, sometimes I'm like, why did I have to be a preacher's daughter? Because, Lord, I feel like they little battles just... Like, I'm going to get tested all the time because of, you know, the vein that we're all in. And I'm like, it seems like other people on the outside just have it so easy. They can live their life however they want to live and get everything they want to get. But we all know at the end of the day, you know, what the ultimate goal is, and that's for all of us to make it. So it doesn't matter what you may see, and then also how people perceive things to be on social media. Because I've fallen into that little hole before too, seeing people with all of their successes. But we never truly know what's going on behind a picture, right? A picture is only a moment. You don't know what someone is going through, you know, behind that picture, you know. So what are some of the things that we do during difficult times where we feel like things are not going right for us, you know? And I'm sure I'm not the only person who has felt this way before. So, I mean, what can you do about it? Do we pray? You know, do we fast? Do we call on our leaders? Like, y'all know me. I like interaction, so you can kind of give me some feedback.
Well, I learned now I have to acknowledge what's going on.
Okay.
So don't. Yeah.
Acknowledge what's going on, and I think that is very important as well, because a lot of times we, as black people, also, you know, like to kind of sweep things under the rug, or not really address the issues that's going on. But yeah, that's very important. We do need to acknowledge those things. So I'm personally learning that I have to, like, I'm a Google fanatic. I Google anything. Like, I'll Google how to tie my shoe if I need to. But I have learned to Google and look up things like, if I'm feeling this way, what scripture can help me in this moment? And then I just pretty much go through that entire chapter, and usually I find my answer to whatever I need. So what can we do about it? What are some of the things that we can do? And here's a question for you all as well. Have you ever found yourself lacking faith in your situation? Have you ever thought, like, I don't know how God gonna do this, you know? I believe in God, I know he's true, but I'm just being honest. Sometimes it looks like, I don't know where it's about to come from. Like, God, yes, I trust you. We say we trust you. We know you are real. You can do all things. But how are you about to do this? So sometimes to us, it seems impossible, even though we have been taught our whole lives, you know, that he can do all things. So we really do have to find our faith during those moments. So that's one of the answers to that question. You know, you have to find your faith. Mm-hmm. So we know we have it. We've been taught since CJ's age, you know, who God is and who he is in us. And we've seen the miracles that he's done. But sometimes when it comes to our personal selves, it seems like, oh, it's just me. Like, maybe he won't do that for me. You know, so some people battle with those thoughts as well, but we have to understand that those things are possible. So in those times, you do have to find your faith. So going to the story of Job, and this is, for those of you who don't know, I'm sure you all do, where God was testing Job to basically see his true colors, putting in, you know, layman's terms, to see who Job really was, to see if he would ever doubt him. And so usually when I read this story, I'll say that, you know, Job really never, he never doubted God. But as I went further down in chapter 3, this is when Job just was like kind of fed up and was like, all right, now, you know, I ain't done nothing wrong. I've been good to you and you just tear me down, taking everything from me. So I'm going to read some of these. Actually, I'm just going to try to read fast. I want to be before you all. Job chapter 3, it says, after this opened Job his mouth and cursed his day. And Job spake and he said, let the day perish wherein I was born, and the night in which it was said, there is a man-child conceived. Let that day be darkness. Let not God regard it from above, neither let the light shine upon it. Let darkness and the shadow of death stain it. Let a cloud dwell upon it. Let the blackness of the day terrify it. As for that night, let darkness seize upon it. Let it not be joined unto the days of the year. Let it not come into the number of the months. Lo, let that night be solitary. Let no joyful voice come therein. Let them curse it that curse the day, who are ready to raise up their mourning. Let the stars of the twilight thereof be dark. Let it look for the light, but have none. Neither let it see the dawning of the day, because it shut not up the doors of my mother's womb, nor hid sorrow from mine eyes. Why died I not come from the womb? Why did I not give up the ghost when it came out the belly? Why did the knees prevent me, or why the breast that I should suck? For now I should have lain still and been quiet. I should have slept. Then had I been at rest with kings and counselors of the earth, which build desolate places for themselves, or with princes that had gold, who filled their houses with silver, or as a hidden, ultimately birth, I had not been, as infants which never saw light. There the wicked cease from troubling, and there the weary be at rest. There the prisoners rest together. They hear not the voice of the oppressor. The small and great are there, and the servant is free from his master. Wherefore is life given to him that is in misery, and life unto the bitter in soul, which long for death, but it cometh not, and dig for it more than for the hidden treasures, which rejoice exceedingly and are glad when they have, I'm sorry, when they can find the grave. Why is life given to a man whose way is hid, in whom God hath hedged him? From my sighing cometh before I eat, and my roarings are poured out like the waters. For the thing which I greatly fear is coming upon me, and that which I was afraid of is come unto me. I was not in safety, neither had I rest, neither was I quiet, yet trouble came. So that kind of reminded me of how we feel sometimes, like, oh, I go to church, I fast, I pray, I do all of this, and yet trouble comes. That shows us we are not eliminated from anything that could happen. And it brought me back to last week when Bishop told us we are going to be tested. He just put the word forth, and he strictly told us he's coming to do what?
Test us.
He's coming to check our peace. And he's done just that. So then, fast forwarding to Job 38. And I'm going to read the New International Version because I like to dummy things down a little bit for my understanding, not yours. So I'm going to read that really quick. So it's Job 38. It says, then the Lord spoke to Job out of the storm. And this is 38, I think, through 41. I'm only going to read 38. And God is basically humbling Job in this moment. And so whatever you are going through in this moment, if you're feeling like you're questioning God or whatever, you know, may seem like you may ask, you know, why is this happening to me? This is what the Lord said to Job in his storm. And he said, who is this that obscures my plans with words without knowledge? Brace yourself like a man. I will question you, and you shall answer me. So he will test you, basically, is what he's saying. He's going to question your faith sometimes. So where were you when I laid the earth's foundation? Tell me if you understand. Who marked off its dimensions? Surely you know. Who stretched a measuring line across it? On what were its footing set? Or who laid its cornerstone? While the morning stars sing together and all the angels shouted for joy, who shut up the sea behind doors when it burst forth from the womb, when I made the clouds its garment and it wrapped in its thick darkness, when I fixed limits for it and set its doors and bars in place, when I said, this far you may come no further. Here is where your poor waves halt. Have you ever given orders to the morning or shown the dawn its place that it might take earth by its edges and shake the wicked out of it? The earth takes shape like clay under seal. Its futures stand out like those of a garment. The wicked are denied their light and their upraised arm is broken. Have you journeyed to the springs of the sea or walked into the recess of the deep? Have the gates of death been shown to you? Have you seen the gates of the deepest darkness? Have you comprehended the vast expanses of the earth? Tell me if you know all of this. What is the way of the adult of light? And where does darkness reside? Can you take them to their places? Do you know the paths to their dwellings? Surely you know, for you were already born. You have lived so many years. Have you entered the storehouses of the snow? Or see the storehouses of the hail, which I reserve from times of trouble, for days of war and battle. What is the way to the place where the lightning is dispersed, or the place where the east winds in the scatter all over the earth? Who cuts a channel of the torrents of the rain and a path for the thunderstorms to water a land where no one lives? An uninhabited desert to satisfy and desolate wasteland and make it sprout with grass. Does the rain have a father? Who fathers the drops of dew? From whose womb comes the ice? Who gives birth to the frost from the heavens? When the waters become hard as a stone, when the surface of the deep is frozen, can you bind the chains of the plesides when... Can you loosen Orion's belt? Can you bring forth the constellations in their seasons or lead the bear out of its cubs? Do you know the laws of heaven?
Jesus.
Can you set up God's dominion over the earth? Can you raise your voice to the clouds? And can you cover yourself with a flood of water? Do you send lightning bolts on their way? Do they report to you? Here we are. Who gives the... Evis wisdom or gives the roosters understanding? Who has the wisdom to count the clouds? Who can tip over the water jars of the heavens? When the dust becomes hard and the clods of the earth stick together, do you hunt the prey for the lioness and satisfy the hunger of the lions? When they crouch in their dens or lie in wait in the thicket, who provides food for the raven? When it's young and cry out to God and wonder about lack for food, do you know when the mountain goats give birth? And he goes on for several chapters asking him, do you do all of these things? Do you know all of these things? So it was literally, I mean, you guys should read it. It's 38 through 41, where he basically humbles him. You know, the things that you are saying, basically telling Job, you don't even understand the mass of what it takes to run this earth. You know, he even broke it down to, in one part, I was like, whoa, basically telling him, I have two beasts that can kill you and think nothing about it if I say it. You know, but in the mix of all that he's going through, he's still kind of telling him as well, I'm protecting you from that. You have no idea, like, from the atoms of in everything that is connected of what is taking place in this world, still what you're going through, I'm protecting you in the mix. You may have lost these things, but I am still keeping you. And so the conclusion of that is, you know, no matter what comes, good or bad, we can trust God's wisdom, because he just explained and continues to explain through the rest of the chapters everything that he does. So what little incidents or, you know, things that we go through, those are very minute and minor to the things that he continuously operates, whether we're here or not. You know, he still has to take care of this entire world. So he's bigger than what we can understand. So whatever we may be going through, whatever trials we feel like we are going through, he's bigger than that. You know, so like I said earlier, find your faith. If you want to go back and read through this, if you're feeling like whatever you're going through is kind of impossible for God to fix, go back and read those things, like in the where he humbled Job in those scriptures there. Go back and read those. If he can do those things, then we know that he can work out whatever we're facing. Amen.
Amen.
And that's all I have.
That was good. Amen.
Amen. Awesome, awesome words on today. Amen. Stretch your hands towards the speakers. Amen. Father, we just thank you, Lord God, for everything that has transpired on today. We thank you, Lord, for these, your people, Lord God. We thank you for the speakers, Lord God. One sister, Jessica, that pressed her way out, Lord God. One mother, Bridges, Lord God, that pressed her way out, Father God, and then taught us on today, Lord God, about the willingness to love God. And we thank you, Lord God, for Sister Sade, Lord God, for every trial, Lord God, that she's been through, Lord God, the tribulations. Father, we know all three are going through for their good and your glory, Father God. And we thank you, Lord God, for using them on today, Lord God, teaching us and allowing us to see, Lord God, no matter what it looks like, you're still in control and in charge, Father God. And we thank you for all things that you're doing in this season, Father God. We ask you to bless them, meet their needs on today, Lord God, strengthen them like never before. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen.
You can slide our hearts, Lord. You can slide our hearts, Lord.
Stepping on our feet all over the building.
Sanctify my heart, Lord.
The word of God is royal, is pure.
Sanctify.
How many believe that?
My heart,
I said the word of God is royal. And you come from royal priesthood.
Amen.
And we thank God for grace. We thank God for his mercy. Somebody say, God, let your glory fall down. In these trying times. Somebody say, Holy Ghost. Settle inside of me. Settle inside my neighborhood. Settle on my job. Come on, somebody. Holy Ghost. You got to have the Holy Ghost. Close those eyes and let's just worship him. Thank you, Jesus. Son of David, have mercy. Father God, I send you right now, God, to Elder Madison's residence. We know that place right now currently is waiting on you. Well, God, we send you to New Orleans, God, where her cousins and relatives, God, her sisters, God, Father God, our uncles, aunties, God, those that got the news, Lord, we send strength to that family. And I thank you, Lord, because Elder always said and gave a shout out to the bereaved families. She always included them in her prayers. We know she had such a time last year where it seemed like every month she was losing somebody. But God gave her a phone call, 7:30, yesterday, Sabbath morning. What a good time to go on. The Sabbath day. A day that he said that we ought to rejoice and be glad in. The day he truly set aside for worship and praise. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Somebody say, glory to God. I really need you to mean that. Don't say it because I'm telling you to say it. You got to say yes to your will, God, yes to your way. Because God's will has been done. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, somebody. Come on, come on.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm trying to take you somewhere.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Father God. Have your will, Father God.
You got to close those eyes. Empty your brain. You got to close those eyes, Mimi. You got to close those eyes and say, Father, I totally surrender to you. I told Pastor Smith, who also is my lawyer in Florida, I said, the death angel is riding. I said, the death angel is riding. The death angel is riding.
Come on, somebody. Worry about that. I got that. I don't want no touch of nothing.
Okay.
That's why the stuff screwed up now. My mic is broke already.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.